have been playing Immortal Fenyx Rising for about 15 days now, and I have finally completed the main story as well as a lot of different side quests. I've also explored each and every bit of the entire map of this game, and now I think that I'm completely ready in order to put out my thoughts and my full reviews on Immortal Fenyx Rising. Now, before we do a deep dive into the entire review, I just want to give you guys my final impression of the game, what I personally feel before we go into all the in-depth details and everything about this game. Now, I would say that Immortal Fenyx Rising is a really good game, but for me personally, I think there were a lot of things that was really disappointing in this game. And like most of the open world RPG games that I've been playing for years now, I would say that my first impression on this game is that it is a pretty average game overall. So I'm going to be starting off this full review with the main story writing and how good is the story for this game without really sharing any of the story spoilers in this game. Now, the basic concept of this storyline is Prometheus telling a story to Zeus on how they can save the world of gods with the help of a mortal soul called Phoenix. Now, in my opinion, the storyline of this game is pretty average, and the way they actually tell you the story in this game is what actually caught a lot of my attention, because unlike all the other RPG games that I've played so far, Immortal Fenyx Rising has a completely different way of telling you a story, where Prometheus has this really funny, awkward conversation with Zeus, and he basically tells Zeus a huge story about Fenyx and how he saved the world of gods and all that stuff. And the conversation between Prometheus and Zeus is kind of made in a way so that the storyline feels much more funnier than it really is. Now, in a lot of different cases, the game has too many cringy dialogues, and to be honest, too much of these cringy jokes kind of make the game feel more funnier, I guess. It's up to your personal opinion on how well your sense of humor really is. So if I have to rate the main story of this game, then I would give it about a 7 out of 10. So that's going to be my final score for just the story of this game. And now let's move on to the RPG mechanics. Now, if you guys have played Assassin's Creed Odyssey or even Assassin's Creed Valhalla, there are a lot of different RPG combat mechanics that are like imported into this game, especially when you're using this huge axe in this game. The combat kind of felt very close to what I felt with Assassin's Creed Valhalla when you're swinging these huge axes. And in terms of gameplay and your character movement and controls and all that stuff, it is extremely similar to Assassin's Creed Odyssey. At the same time, it is also very identical to this other game called Breath of the Wild. Now, I don't know how many of you guys have played Breath of the Wild, and if you guys are a fan of that game, then I'm pretty sure, hands down, that you guys are going to absolutely enjoy this game no matter what. But if you're not a fan of Breath of the Wild, nor if you guys are a fan of Assassin's Creed Odyssey, then I think that this game is not going to be too much of your type, but still, you can go ahead and try it out and see if this is what you like. It's completely up to your choice. Now, when it comes to RPG mechanics, the loot system and the open world and how you can basically level up your character and find new weapons, gears, and all that stuff. Now, that is something I really liked about how Immortal Fenyx Rising handled all of these loot system in this game, because looking back at all the other Ubisoft RPG games like Assassin's Creed Odyssey, as well as Assassin's Creed Valhalla, for example, where there are like so many different complicated loots, especially in Odyssey, whereas in Valhalla, Ubisoft kind of rectified that and made the loot system much better, I guess. But in terms of Immortal Fenyx Rising, the RPG loot in this game is absolutely fantastic. And the one big thing I absolutely loved about this game is that every time you want to go ahead and complete a main mission, or even if you want to try and get some of these loot items or the loot chest in which you're going to be finding all of these different gears and weapons and all kind of upgrades, these chests are going to be hidden behind a very huge puzzle. So everything you do in this game will involve a very challenging puzzle that you will have to solve. And I personally took so many hours trying to retry all of these different puzzles, failing and then retrying again and failing. And sometimes I was extremely frustrated that I was not able to solve some of the puzzles, and then it took me hours and hours together. And unfortunately, since the game was not released, we don't really have any tutorials on YouTube to look up and see on how I can complete this puzzle. So that was a big bummer. But now that the game is released and YouTubers are going to be posting a lot of those guide videos on how you can solve different puzzles, so it's going to be much easier for you guys if you do end up looking at all of these tutorials, guides, and stuff like that. But I've got to say, though, all of these different puzzles in this game is what makes this game extremely special. And I don't really think that Ubisoft has ever made a game that has like this huge of a complex puzzle system other than Prince of Persia games, which was back in the days. And those games had some really, really fun puzzles that we had to solve in order to power the level and progress through the story missions. And if I have to be completely honest here, I think that Immortal Fenyx Rising copied a lot of different puzzle mechanics from Breath of the Wild, and that's of course not a bad thing, because Breath of the Wild is a great game and people seem to have enjoyed the game, so making puzzles much better or even similar to what Breath of the Wild has achieved is always a good thing. And I think that Immortal Fenyx Rising think has done a really good job in terms of how you handle all of these different missions, loot systems, and all of these different RPG mechanics in the game, of course. And now let's move on to the map design, the map size, and all the exploration part in this game. How does the open world exploration feel in Immortal Fenyx Rising? Now, the first thing I've got to say, though, that Ubisoft has really outdone themselves in terms of designing the map for this game, because unlike Assassin's Creed Odyssey or even Assassin's Creed Valhalla, for example, the map in Immortal Fenyx does not feel as large as what these two games have to offer, and at the same time, it doesn't feel small at all. Like, Ubisoft has achieved this perfect balance in which the map doesn't feel too large or too small. It just fits perfectly into how the storyline plays, and the map contains 6 different regions, and all of these 6 different regions of this game look completely different from each other. And that is something I absolutely love in terms of how Ubisoft has designed this map. So you're not going to be finding any of those copy-paste materials all around the map or any place that looks similar to the other place that you visited. So every different region that you visit is going to be completely different, and each region would give you a different vibe and different feel, which is going to make your gameplay as well as your open world exploration much better. Now, another thing I absolutely hate about this game, and I'm being extremely serious here, like, I absolutely hate this thing in terms of how much distance Ubisoft decided to put between the camera and the player. Because in almost all the new Ubisoft games, let's take for example Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Breakpoint had a really bad camera angle, and then Ubisoft decided to fix it later on in the days, and I still think that the camera angle is not as good as what was shown in the E3 trailers. And moving on to a more similar game, Assassin's Creed Odyssey, the camera angle in that game was also pretty messed up, and the same was followed up for Assassin's Creed Valhalla. And I don't really understand where you're playing a third-person action RPG game where you have all of these different cosmetic items where you can customize your characters and all that stuff, but you can't really see your characters up close unless you decide to go use the photo mode, because this game puts the characters so far away that it kind of feels like you're playing some kind of a MOBA game. And I really hope that Ubisoft doesn't do the same with all of their upcoming games, because they're kind of ruining the camera angle for me. And if this is the case, I don't think I'm going to be enjoying any of the upcoming RPG games that Ubisoft is trying to make, because they seem to be loving this huge distance between the player and the camera. I don't know why they do this. Now, I'm guessing that the reason they want to put such a distance between the player and the camera angle is probably because they don't want to show that bad texture rendering models of your 3D characters. So that could be probably why they're doing this, or they could also be an entirely different reason as well. But this is not something I personally enjoy. Now, of course, I do understand that opinions are going to be different from my perspective to yours. Some people might enjoy this camera angle. Some people might be the same as me. So at the end of the day, this is my personal opinion on what I personally feel about this game for the experience I have had for the past 15 days of playing this game. Now, let's talk about how Ubisoft have designed some of these characters and how good are these characters in the main story mode, and how good is your Fenyx? Is your Fenyx going to feel somewhat like a bot, or is he going to have some kind of real emotions or some characteristics in the game? And the answer to that is Fenyx kind of feels more like an RPG character, but at the same time, Ubisoft has done a really good job in terms of connecting the players to all of these different story characters in the game, because a lot of different characters you're going to be meeting in the main story missions, some of them are really funny and exciting to meet, and some characters are real creepy and cringy at the same time. So there's going to be all kind of different emotions mixed into the storyline and how they kind of build up all of these different characters in this game. So I would say that Ubisoft has done a pretty good job in terms of designing the characters in this game. Now, finally, what I want to talk about is the optimization of this game. How does this game run on the PC version? How does it run on the console version, both on PlayStation, Xbox, as well as different PC graphics cards? This game is extremely well optimized on the console versions, but on the PC version, I would say that it felt more like any other Ubisoft optimized games, because even after the day one patch of this game, I had so many crashes on my PC version. I also tried this game on my PS4 Pro and the game had absolutely no issues, whereas on the PC version, I experienced a lot of different problems with this game in terms of your frame rates, your graphics cards overheating, your CPU overheating. There were so many different issues with how this game was optimized on the PC. Now, I tried this game on 3 different PC builds, one being the GTX 1080 Ti, the second one being RTX 2080 Ti, as well as the RTX 3090, which I recently just got. And as far as what the performance goes, I was playing this game on the maximum ultra settings on all the 3 cards at 1440p resolution. And now, as far as what the performance goes, the game is running at 55 to about 70 frames per second on the NVIDIA GTX 1080 Ti. And on the 2080 Ti, you were getting somewhere about 55 to 80 FPS, just a 5 FPS boost on the 2080 Titan version. version. And then comes the RTX 3090, which gave me about 70 to 130 FPS on the maxed out settings at 1440p resolution. Now, the biggest issue that I had is that all of these three different cards, upon playing this game for over an hour, the temperatures were raising all the way up to 80 degrees Celsius. And 80 degrees is not a very safe temperature for cards like 1080 as well as the 2080, but I think the 3090 can easily handle the 80 degrees. So as far as how the optimization goes, I personally think that it was not as good as what I expected for the PC versions to be. And that is really disappointing on how many crashes of this game I had to go through, even with the day one patch being added, as well as my temperatures of the card and CPU raising all the way up to 80 degrees. And ladies and gentlemen, I think we have now come to the end of this review, and it is now time I give out my final score for this game out of 10. And as far as what I could fairly think of the score, I would personally give this game a 7 out of 10, and that is going to be my final score for Immortal Fenyx Rising. So these are just my personal takes, so let me know in the comments if you guys are going to be getting Immortal Fenyx Rising. Are you guys going to be trying this game out? Let me know all of your thoughts and opinions down below in the comment section. I would love to read all of your comments and see what do you guys think about this game, and are you guys excited for Immortal Fenyx Rising. Now, if you guys did go on and enjoy this review or even found this useful, then make sure to go ahead and leave a like, because your like is always appreciated and it does help support my channel. So please make sure to take a few seconds of your time. And also, if you guys are new to this channel, then you should probably know that I cover all the open world RPG games like Cyberpunk 2077, Assassin's Creed, and so many other games as well. So make sure you guys go ahead, subscribe, and turn the little bell notification on so you don't miss out on all the upcoming videos that I upload every single day. With that being said, I hope you guys have a blast of the day, and I'll see you guys on tomorrow's video. Until then, take it easy, fans, and goodbye.